Wisdom in Yi Jing Feng Shui is the foundation of world peace. Good day to audience around the world. Welcome to Professional Yi Jing Feng Shui TV Station, Weixin TV Station. Today is Monday, March 4th, 2019, and it's now 11:30 p.m. in Taiwan. I'm Fiona Zhang Xinfang. On the altar of Taiji Tian Plaza of Changjishan Weixin Shengjiao Taichung Branch Temple stood the statue of Wang Chan Lao Zu. The 5 meters tall bronze-made statue is undergoing traditional gilding process following Wang Chan Lao Zu's holy edict and Grand Master Hun Yuan Chanshi's instruction. On February 25th, Abbot Master Yuan Yi administered the spiritual recitation rite and informed the heaven. On February 26th, they proceeded the purification rite at 6 in the morning, and the gilding process commenced at 8. Let's take a look.
The gold gilding construction of the golden statue of Wang Chan Lao Zu at Taiji Tian Weixin Shengjiao Taichung Branch Temple Taiji Tian Plaza started on the 26th after being gold gilded. The golden statue of Wang Chan Lao Zu will shine glassily the glass radiance upon all sentient beings in the Ten Dharma realm. A gold gilding ritual was held in the evening on the 25th. Above Master Yuan Yi burned incense to refer to Wang Chan Lao Zu. A Dharma offering was prepared for Dharma protectors of the heavenly dragon to wish for good fortune and the success of the construction. Master Yuan Yi elaborated on the ritual to virtuous pharaohs.
几亥年的正月22号梳洗，我们今天为了老祖台中道场世界和平原点，台中道场。大精神要安心的工程啊，这伟大的工程啊，最殊胜的工程，来诵经来祈福，目的就是要使安精神的工程能够顺利，能够圆满，没有障碍啊。我们今天啊，这么多的诵经师来诵经，我们共同的一个信念，因为王禅老祖实在是我们最感恩啊，最殊胜的我们的啊这个大神啊，我们每一个人都受到他的庇佑啊，都受到他的赐福，我们都存着无限的感恩。今天我们用经典啊，王禅老祖玄妙真经以及天德经来供养天龙护法，来供养啊太极啊这些护法神将，我们来供养他。
The ritual was held shortly. Master Yuan Yi offered the fresh flowers and the fruits while chanters took charge of the Dharma offering. Early in the morning of the 27th, Master Yuan Yi purified the construction site with holy water and conducted a purifying ritual to eliminate the misfortune. Construction workers then started to set up the construction site, anticipating the construction to be successful under Wang Chan Lao Zu's gracious radiance and guidance to world peace. Weixin News, Taichung.
For this week's rituals and activities, Changjishan Weixin Shengjiao Tianyi Branch Temple hosted the Benediction and Disaster Elimination Ritual to celebrate the establishment of the temple and express gratitude to Buddha on February 23rd. There, they recited the scriptures and hoped that, relying on Wang Chan Lao Zu's power of virtue, the neighborhood is secured and remains safe and sound.
Tanji Mountain Weixin Shengjiao Tianyi Branch Temple launched the Anniversary Benediction and Disaster Elimination Ritual on February 23rd. They sincerely invited Master Yuan Yao and chanters to administer the rite. The abbot of Master Yuan Dao and Master Yuan De lead virtuous fellows to recite scriptures for inviting Wangcan Lao Zu Gui Gu Immortal Master Da Tianzun Monument, Buddhas and Bodhisattvas. Compassionate radiance, they arrived at Imandola, received the feasted Dharma offerings. Master Yuan Dao piously worshipped Buddha to thank Buddhas and Bodhisattvas and asked their blessing on Tianyi Branch Temple Turner Dharma Well. Weixin virtuous fellows are safe and disciples are in good health. Tianyi Branch Temple was dedicated to the Chinese ancestors Shenlongyan Emperor Da Tianzun Monument and Wangcan Laozu Da Tianzun Monument. In order to show their spirits benefiting others and helping people, Tianyi Branch Temple gave lecture on herbal medicine research and integrated the wondrous Dharma of Yi Jing Feng Shui to help virtuous fellows who have been suffering from illness for many years. Yi Jing Feng Shui could show low suffering disciples a bright path and enlighten them that only improve their living place with Feng Shui principles and the karma are undone can they get rid of illness and worries. With the power of Wangcan Laozu and Shenlongyan Emperor, all sentient beings could be saved and liberated karmic affinity. The virtuous fellows of Tianyi Branch Temple offer delicacy and the magnificent offerings. They hope that with the power of Buddhas, they can turn each grain into numerous ones and make an offering of sweet stew to the spirits from the three realms. They pray that all sentient beings can get rid of ego grasping, resolve grievances, attain enlightenment, and achieve the Bodhi together. Weixin News Tianyi Branch Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon. Now we're showing you this week's Weixin Shengjiao feature story. Let's watch it together.
Hello everyone, I'm Yi Tuofo. Welcome for watching Weixin Shengjiao feature story. Nowadays, almost every family has a car, so parking is always a big problem in the city. Originally, there aren't enough parking spaces, and many of them are even occupied by merchants or residents. They think the parking space in front of the door belongs to them. So they barricade off the space with plastic buckets, chairs, flower pots, or even a no parking iron frame to declare the ownership. Everyone knows that the road belongs to the government and it's for public use. However, some people are selfish, occupying government property for their own convenience and depriving others of their right. There was once a believer, Mr. Tsai, who operated a snack bar. Every day, when he opened the door, there was already someone parking in front of the store. He felt inconvenient, so he bought two plants and put them on the both sides of the door to occupy the parking space. Then he could enter the store easily without any obstacles. The odd thing was that there were fewer and fewer guests, and the business was getting worse and worse from that day. In less than a month, there were only two or three guests every day. Mr. Tsai was very anxious, so he hurried to Xianfo Temple to ask for help from Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi. Then Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi applied Yi Jing divination and found that the two plants in front of the door had formed the feng shui of the battle of the dragon and the tiger, which had blocked the energy or qi of the front door. Mr. Tsai asked what to do about it. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi suggested him to remove the things in front of the door. Therefore, Mr. Tsai immediately removed the plants after he went back, and the guests started to come back again. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi instructed that occupying public property without giving others convenience will lose your virtues and merits. It's also against the principles of Yi Jing Feng Shui. If everyone passes by the store with a curse or blame, you will suffer the consequences of your actions in the end. There was another believer who opened a grocery store in the market. As the business was very good and the space was not big enough, he broke the arcade in the front as part of his store. Then everyone passing by his store had to make a detour, and his business kept decreasing afterwards. One day, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi just passed by his store and took a look of the feng shui for him. The feng shui of the store was found to be extremely bad due to the both sides of the arcade were blocked and the negative energy of wind would blow into the store directly. That's the main reason to hurt his business. Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi instructed him to leave others a path to go through and don't let the public to generate resentment. At the same time, he must repent immediately in order to resume his business. Through these two cases, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi instructed the disciples, if we influence others due to our selfishness, it will not only damage our merits and virtues, but also set a very bad example for the next generation. Then the next generation will definitely create enmity and hatred with the public in the future. It is the fate and karmic affinity to bring us all together in the mundane world again. We should help each other instead of taking advantages of others for our own benefits. Not to mention that it will even destroy the feng shui of our own. As Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi instructed, a person with sufficient merits will have the fortunes and blessings to deserve a feng shui treasure land. We shall encourage ourselves together with it. Thank you for watching today's feature story. Peace and joy to you and your family. We'll see you next time.
On August 3rd, 2017, asked by Professor Lucas Pocani of the Department of Religious Studies of University of Vienna, Austria, Chanji Shanwei Xinsheng Jiao has donated 192 Dharma Treasure Series books to be their first collection. The Dharma Treasure Series books contains a total of 192 books classified into 24 categories, including View All Perspectives of Yi Jing Feng Shui, Gui Gu Zihar Dharma in Taiwan, Feng Shui Lectures on Young Residents, World Peace Promoter, Grandmaster Hun Yuan Canshi, Research on Chi Yu Culture, The Culture Begotten by the Three Ancestors of Chinese Civilization and Its Contribution to World Peace, and etc. Recently, Research and Development Center for Religious Affairs of Weixin Shenjiao has collected and sent books as well as audio and video materials, including In Praise of the Heavenly Might of the Originator Wang Chan Laozu and other series in total of 33 items of Dharma Treasure of Our Religious Culture to University of Vienna on February 27th. This is the second stage of their collection plan. The following footage shows more about this important academic development and exchange.
Chanji Mountain Weixin Shenjiao expands international exchanges and cooperation aggressively recently. In recent years, we can see some fruitful results, especially in international academic exchanges. The director of Research and Development Center for Religious Affairs of Weixin Shenjiao, Fiona Xinfeng Zheng, plays essential role to attend important international religious conference overseas. Meanwhile, she shares Weixin Shenjiao Dharma Treasure Series to many international academic institutions. After the first batch delivered to University of Vienna in Austria on August 3, 2017, which covered 24 series with 192 books, the second batch was delivered on March 1, 2019. We hope these books can enable foreigners to understand more about the true spirit of Weixin Shenjiao root of what we stand, compassion of Wangchan Lao Tzu, and desire of world peace held by Grandmaster Hun Yuan Chan Shi in mind. The book donation idea originated on May 15, 2017, while the director of Research and Development Center for Religious Affairs of Weixing Shenjiao, Fiona Xinfeng Zhang, led a team visited Dr. Lucas Pokorny of the Institute of Religious Studies at the University of Vienna. At the time, both sides worked together to wrap up book list of the first batch. Coming up with the second batch, there are 33 series with 21 books and 12 sets of DVDs. They covered complementary on Wangchan Lao Tzu's heavenly greatness, disaster elimination and benediction ritual, Guigu Zihar Dharma in Taiwan, documentary of the sealing ceremony for the holy lotus seat of Guiguzi's mega statue, Feng Shui of the Earth, Feng Shui lectures on Yang residences, great ceremony for the unified worship of Chinese ancestors, and so on. After selection has been done attentively, Research and Development Center starts to keep a log recording book list, prepare introduction of the book in English, design book Tommy Band, pack everything in boxes for delivery to University of Vienna. We expect this series boosts Weixing Shenjiao to be known by more and more people, and people from everywhere in the world can work together to turn the Dharma wheel peacefully. Weixing News Taichung Branch Temple.
Take a break. We will come back soon. On April 27th, Chanji Shan Weixing Shenjiao is going to host the annual Wangchan Lao Tzu birthday celebration and water earth ritual. This is the 22nd water earth ritual, which will last for 8 days until May 4th. In the headquarters Shenfo Temple, there are 7 kinds of mandalas and the spiritual residence for the lonely souls. The revered monks will piously invite Wangchan Lao Tzu and Buddha, Bodhisattva, the deities, holy saints and sages to descend to the ritual for empowering the spirits in 10 Dharma directions. In the midst of scripture recitation and offerings, the spirits are blessed to gain wisdom and fed with nice fruits and foods. The harmony of the material world and the underworld serves as the power which ensures world peace.
March 26th of the lunar calendar is the birthday of Wangchan Lao Tzu of Weixing Shenjiao. Chanji Shan Xianfo Temple of Weixing Shenjiao will hold a ritual to celebrate the annual Wangchan Lao Tzu birthday celebration and water earth ritual. Master Mingding and eminent monks have invited to hold the ritual to transcend 6 kinds of rebirths, ancestors, person karma creditor in the past lives, Dharma run spirits, and wandering spirits to join the ritual. The 2019 Wangchan Lao Tzu birthday celebration and water earth ritual will open on April 27th to let the spirit faring light and summoning soul. The ritual will persist 8 days until May 4th. Everyone who wants to join the celebration is welcoming. A special rite in the mandala is to keep the precepts for departed spirit will open on the first day of the ritual on May 2nd. According to a scripture, entering the Dharma Sea, the latter is fundamental. Crossing the river of death, ring for the ship. This special rite is for the departed spirit to get rid of the bitter world, and it will tell by the Vajraguru, and the people in the real world will accept this for the departed spirits. If there is virtuous fellow want to transcend the ancestors to thank their parents and transcend their own karma creditor in the past lives to let their life could have a good way to live, and etc., all of them could accept the rite in the ritual. We welcome everyone to join the ritual together. Weixing News at Changjishan Xianfo Temple.
Continue on an important ritual. Under the instruction of Grandmaster 混元禅师, 禅机山维新圣教 headquarters, 先佛 temple, piously summons the 500 Arahants to empower and turn the world peace wheel at the world peace ritual. Let's take a look.
On 26, 禅机山维新圣教 headquarters 先佛 temple hung red lanterns at ultimate bless hall to invite 500 arhats to bless for turning the Dharma wheel of world peace together. In the morning of the 14th day of the first lunar month, Grandmaster 混元禅师assigned Master 元瑶 to report the statement on the 15th days of the first lunar month, Taiwan 祖师's birthday, to invite 500 arhats radiantly arrive at ultimate bless hall. Dharma masters recite.Inviting 500 arhats to bless for turning the Dharma wheel of world peace home every day. Virtuous fellows hand 500 red lanterns in front of the ultimate bless hall and made an offering of firecrackers in the four corners and gold sliver papers monies for 500 arhats and the Dharma protectors of Dragon Heaven. When the message about offering the lanterns for 500 arhats released, all the lanterns are offered by virtuous fellows immediately.Scripture recitation rites started from 15th day of the first lunar month. In 1983, Taiwan 祖师 reminded Grandmaster 混元禅师that Grandmaster 混元禅师, before immeasurable kelpas you promised Amitabha Buddha that you will look for 500 arhats who will have great achievements and benefit the sentient beings. Now, Grandmaster 混元禅师 has been propagating the Dharma and benefiting all human beings for 37 years. He never forgets this mission.And has arranged the seats for 500 arhats studios at Tathagata Garden. 500 arhats have been invited to descend to the mundane world and turn the Dharma wheel of world peace. Weixin News, Xianfu Temple.
Grandmaster 混元禅师 reveals the profound wisdom of Yi Jing Feng Shui in simple language. He integrates the art of divination, unveils the mysteries of Yi Jing Feng Shui in the hearts of the public, and creates a wonderful life for you and me with the right belief. Thank you for tuning in today. Please stay tuned at 11:30 p.m. on every Monday and 11:30 in the morning and 4 o'clock in the afternoon on every Tuesday for every week's Weixin News on Weixin TV. Wang Chan Lao Zu bless you and your family. World peace.See you next week.